Good evening, parents, friends, distinguished guests, teachers, and fellow graduates. Welcome to the virtual commencement ceremony for the class of 2020. This day is about us and what we've accomplished through hard work and perseverance. Although this day is not exactly what we were imagining just a few months ago, I'm hoping it will at least bring comfort to know that this sacrifice is keeping us safe. The class of 2020 is unique in a lot of ways, but mainly because we have something in common with seniors all over the country. In spite of everything that has transpired over the past few months, we were able to keep the visions of our futures clear and not stop pressing forward despite the unforeseen circumstances. When I think of my classmates here at Atholton, I think of future medical professionals, entrepreneurs, teachers, athletes, and maybe if we get lucky, famous TikTokers. All are certainly within reach because we are ready to conquer just about anything life throws our way. Atholton High School was home away from home to us for these last 4 years, and we should continue to stand proud knowing that this will forever be our school where we shared such a memorable journey. Thank you, parents, for your unwavering support. Thank you, administration, for working so hard to find alternatives for the class of 2020 this year. And thank you, teachers, for going above and beyond what you were called to do to help us be successful in the next chapter of our lives and for making us better. Now please rise for the presentation of colors. Please remove your hats and remain standing for the national anthem and posting of the national colors. Please continue standing until the color guard has concluded.
Hello, everyone. At this time, we would like to recognize our elected officials who are joining us virtually and sending their well wishes and congratulations to the class of 2020. Delegate Vanessa Atterbury. Delegate and my parents' high school math teacher, Eric Ebersol. Delegate Jessica Feldmark. Senator Guy Gazzoni. Delegate Terry Hill. Council Chair Deb Young. Senator Clarence Lamb. Delegate Shane Pendergrass, Councilmember Christiana Rigby, Delegate Jen Tarasa. We are also delighted to have County Executive Dr. Calvin Ball, our Superintendent Dr. Michael Martirano, and Board of Education Member Kirsten Coombs with us, and look forward to hearing their remarks later in our ceremony. Thank you.
Thank you very much, and again, congrats to us. Now I would like to invite Chloe Shader to introduce our first performance.
Elena Wenderoff is a dedicated singer whose areas of expertise include opera, rock, and musical theater. She has been studying music for 10 years now and hopes to do so for the rest of her life. Although attending the University of Virginia to study neurobiology in the fall, she still wants to continue singing in a cappella groups. Ezra Silver Eisenstadt has loved music his entire life. He has been playing piano since he was 5 years old and has since learned the guitar and alto saxophone. In school, he has been a part of the symphonic band, wind ensemble, marching band, and theater department. He plans to take a gap year to pursue music composition and production. After that, he will attend the University of Maryland, College Park, double majoring in theater and government and politics, and minoring in philosophy. Ezra and Elena have been playing music together since eighth grade, and are thrilled to perform one last time in high school. Please welcome Elena Wenderoff on vocals and Ezra Silver Eisenstadt on piano as they perform Vienna by Billy Joel.
Slow down, you crazy child. You're so ambitious for a juvenile. But then if you're so smart, tell me why are you still so afraid? Hey, yeah. Where's the fire? What's the hurry about? You'd better cool it off before you burn it out. You got so much to do and only so many hours in a day. Hey, yeah. But you know that when the truth is told, you can get what you want or you can just get old. You're gonna kick off before you even get halfway through. Ooh, when will you realize Vienna waits for you? Slow down, you crazy child, and take the phone off the hook and disappear for a while. It's alright, you can't afford to lose a day or two. Ooh, when will you realize Vienna waits for you? When will you realize Vienna waits for you?
Next speaker has been a very involved student at Atholton as vice president for the SGA executive board, co-anchor of the Raider Time Review, and active participant in both National Honor Society and Black Student Union, and a four-year track athlete. You have definitely seen him somewhere around the school. Although his major at Towson University will be secondary mathematics education, I think you will all agree that he has a way with words as he reflects on the lessons learned over the past 4 years. Please welcome Isaiah Thaxton.
On August 29, 2016, we took our first steps into the halls of Atholton, not knowing what to expect or what would soon become of us. If there was one word to describe freshman year, it'd be confusing. Everything was confusing, from the hallways, the high school syllabus, strange new teachers, and even seeing that one upperclassman in the back of your freshman algebra class. Overall, freshman year was pretty great, especially for a bunch of kids who are all learning just to be comfortable with each other. Next, it was off to sophomore year. And that's about as much as anyone needs to say about sophomore year, because nothing really exciting happened, except for maybe having that one crazy biology teacher. Junior year was filled with even more confusion, hard classes, thoughts of going to college, and taking the dreaded SAT. But it wasn't all that bad. We had teachers like Ms. Chaudhry to guide us with their thoughtful and occasionally absurd views of life. And we can't forget her sometimes odd conspiracy theories that life is only in fact a simulation. Also in our junior year, the hallways soon became a Mario Kart circuit. Between Mr. Motley's rolly desk and Ms. Whistling's scooter, we spent more time making sure our toes weren't getting run over than looking at our phones. That leads us to what we're ending today, our senior year. A year of decision, rejection, hope, acceptance, definitely some confusion, and lots of interesting memories. Senior year was our time to define what high school meant for us. Will we fall into the hole of senioritis, or do we show up every day and pray for that 5.0 GPA? Some of us became good friends with Mrs. Weinberg and Mrs. Nasir because we were late every day. Before you could even say your name, Ms. Weinberg knew who you were, printed out that receipt, and sent you straight to class. But some of us showed up every day, on time, and ready to conquer the day's schoolwork. Although our time at A-Town was cut short, we still got to experience fun senior memories, whether it was booing teachers at senior meetings, are yelling, "You can't do that," at any sporting event. We also can't forget about watching the freshmen almost burn down the entire school during lunch. In our 4 years at Atholton, we've learned insights into how we should live our daily lives, that we should lead, like Mr. Motley, with courage and acceptance for everyone in our community, and that we can cruise all we want in life, but to get to some places, we'll have to walk. Sorry, Ms. Wislaney. And of course, to be one Raider Nation. Because as we all know, once a Raider, always a Raider. Thank you, Atholton.
This next group has been dancing for the majority of their lives and have been dancing together for the past couple of years as part of Atholton's very talented Palms dance team. Performing is our senior captains of the Palms dance team, Monica Bailey and Riley Law, along with our three other graduating seniors, Tahila Lasula, Taylor James, and Michaela Faraci. Monica, who's been on the Palms dance team since she was a freshman, will be majoring in international business with a minor in Spanish at Salisbury University. Riley, who's been with the team since she was a sophomore, will be attending the University of Tampa, studying biology and participating in ROTC. Taylor, who's been dancing with the team since she was a junior, will be studying biomedical physics and public health with a minor in urban sustainability at Wayne State University. Tahila, who has also been dancing with the team since she was a junior, will be majoring in nursing at Lee University. Michaela, who has been twirling with the team for the past 2 years, will be studying biology at HCC. They all love being a part of the Atholton Palms dance team and plan to keep dancing their lives in some way as they continue their life's journey. Performing the song Before You Go by Lewis Capaldi, please welcome Michaela Faraci, Tahila Lasulo, Taylor James, Riley Law, and Monica Bailey, with a special appearance from their coach.
I fell by the wayside, like everyone else. I hate you, I hate you, I hate you, but I was just kidding myself. Our every moment, I started a place. Cause now that the corner locked, here were the words that I needed to say. When you hurt under the surface, like troubled water running cold. Well, time can heal, but this won't. So never the right time, whenever you're cold. Went little by little by little until there was nothing at all. Our every moment, I started to play. But all I can think about is seeing that look on your face. When you hurt under the surface, like troubled water running cold. Well, time can heal, but this wound.
Speaker really likes trees. In fact, she loves trees so much that she chose what university to attend based on its mascot. The Stanford tree, Liza Goldberg, has spent her high school years leading a double life, high schooler by day and NASA researcher by night, traveling the world to speak on her studies of deforestation at Stanford. She'll major in earth systems science and international relations while continuing her work with NASA and spending a lot of time in the redwoods. Please welcome Liza Goldberg.
parents, teachers, administrators, most of you know us as the protest generation. We're the annoying kids, the ones always raising our hands to point out the right side of the argument. We clog up the streets with our demonstrations, the news with our righteous positions, the peaceful dinner conversations with our radical opinions. We are not shy. But in those words, protest generation, remember this. Our freshman year was 2016. We entered high school as the political stage of our country cracked in two. Sophomore year, and Me Too overwhelmed our relationships. Junior year, and we heard our parents say, "Don't worry," after violence lockdown drills. But we wondered, what if? So what did we do? We poured our hearts and our opinions into Snapchat and Instagram. We painted our thoughts onto posters and marched into school walkouts, into the streets, into the news. We argued in the classroom and in the hallways. Finally, this year, we vote. We've learned that our voices can shout and be heard. But senior year, we found that sometimes actions can be more telling than words. To wear a mask could mean saving a life. To stay inside could mean saving six. We've seen that the actions of a few can spiral into consequences for many. And in turn, we are left with a world unrecognizable to all of us. It is easy to feel that our voices and our lives have been drowned out by this crisis. But sitting in lockdown, we have not lost our opinions, our obsession with defining right and wrong. Instead, we have discovered a new kind of protest. We find that not only our words, but also our interactions with others can make and leave a mark. 20 years from now, we will be sitting in the seats of governors, of congresspeople, of presidents. We will take our words, our actions, our passions, and we will use them to shape a new reality. We walk out of the halls of Atholton virtually with conviction, with the world to save and the knowledge that we will be the ones to do it. Yes, class of 2020, we are the protest generation, but we're also the something to save generation. And we have a duty to become the generation who changes it all. And we will, as soon as we're allowed out of the house. Congratulations, class of 2020. Thank you.
You know our next speaker from his life lessons on the morning announcements each month. Larry Cohen is an Atholton Raider through and through, having been an Atholton parent, booster, and a member of the Howard County Board of Education. More than you may actually know, trust me when I say he cares about you as a community and as unique individuals. As we see seniors graduate each year, they enthusiastically say his closing comments with him, and I encourage you to do that today.
Hello, Atholton Raiders, class of 2020. I'm Larry Cohen, and as always, I hope you're all doing well and, of course, staying healthy and safe. Congratulations, you all did it. This is a very big day for all of you. Thank you so much for the opportunity and privilege to have gotten to know you over the past 4 years. I want you to know that I am honored, how honored I am for you welcoming me into your school and into your lives. I very much appreciate that. You're all very special to me. You have made me feel part of the Atholton family. I want you to also know that I am so very proud of each and every one of you, not only for your accomplishments and achievements, but even more so for the fine young ladies and gentlemen that you are. Parents and family members, thank you for the wonderful young people you have sent us. To my very good friend, Mr. Motley, and all of the Atholton staff, thank you for what you have done for all these wonderful students. You should be very proud of your work also. Job well done. To the graduates, what can I say? Right now, it's all about you. Before my closing comments, I'm going to leave you with three quotes that I hope you will always remember and adhere to. Number one, if you always tell the truth, you don't have to remember what you said. Number two, it's always better to be prepared for an opportunity and not have one than to have an opportunity and not be prepared. Preparation, preparation, preparation. And number three, nobody is good at everything, but everybody is good at something. Each and every one of you is unique and have your own strengths and talents. Use them wisely. And now, for the very last time, special from me to you, the Atholton graduating class of 2020, my closing comments. Work hard, never give up. Maintain your sense of humor. You'll always need that. Use your time wisely. Always do your very best. Have a good positive attitude. Have confidence in yourself and your abilities. Be honest with yourself and others. Respect yourself and others. Always be in control of your attitude, actions, and behaviors. Think before you act and think before you react. Be nice and kind to each other. Follow through on your commitments and responsibilities. Use good judgment. Make good decisions and good choices. Keep both your body and mind healthy and strong, and always keep love in your heart. Stay healthy. Please be careful out there. And as always, and most importantly, because we all love you and care about each and every one of you, please come home safely to your family and friends every day. And now, just a couple of special added comments to you, the class of 2020. No matter where you're off to or where you go from here, my hopes and wishes for you are, may you always be safe, may you always be healthy, may you be happy, may your dreams and hopes of today become your realities of tomorrow. May there always be more laughs than tears. May your principles and values always guide you. May you always treat others the way you want to be treated. May you always have the courage, strength, and ability to continue to move forward and to meet new challenges. May you do great things and inspire others to do the same. May you make a positive difference in the world, and may the world continue to be a better place because you are here. And finally, may your story continue, and may the very best be yet to come. Thank you, as always, for listening. Have a great day. Have a great life. Love to you all. Keep in touch. And of course, keep smiling.
Good evening. My name is Isha Santhosh, and I'm co-president of the SGA Executive Board. It is my honor to introduce this year's Class of 2020 Teacher of the Year, Mr. Jimmy Mauder. Mr. Mauder has been a teacher for 28 years, 26 of which have been here at Atholton High School. Students in his AP Environmental Science and Anatomy and Physiology classes admire Mr. Mauder's genuine love for teaching and the well-being of his students, both academically and emotionally. He fosters curiosity and confidence within his students, encouraging them to make mistakes and learn from those experiences in a comfortable learning environment. Congratulations, Mr. Mauder, on your well-deserved title of Teacher of the Year.
Hello. I stand before you very thankful and honored by the recognition of the class of 2020. I appreciate the kind words and thoughts written regarding my efforts to be your teacher. I will always remember the class of 2020 because of the freshmen I taught in BioGT 3 years ago. I remember that group of students having the guts to take this angry, resting face old man's skeletons and creating scenarios in my classroom. One of my favorites was the skeletons taking dental x-rays on the center lab area. That was quite clever. I never minded the shenanigans, knowing how careful you were with the skeletons. As time continued, I really enjoyed watching many of you perform extremely well in other classes and other situations like sports, drama, music, and dance, to name a few. I enjoyed having many of you return to my classroom, taking other classes I have taught. Besides the group from BioGT, I've enjoyed the privilege of knowing many others of you who have come through my class over the last two years as well. You as a group have been fun to watch grow and mature. And now you've given me a fantastic honor that I will never forget. To those of you that I have not had the privilege to teach, I am sorry that we couldn't cross paths. We as teachers want all of you to succeed in our classrooms and in the future, whatever that future holds for each and every one of you. Our goal is to demonstrate different options and opportunities to find success as we journey together through the curriculum. We're hopeful that some of you will learn and grow as we continue that journey. We hope you understand we learn and grow alongside of you each day. Those green sheets of paper that you fill out, letting us know how we are doing as teachers, have helped us to understand how we have helped you. You give us a chance to see that the work we put into each and every lesson, as well as the time we take to understand each and every one of you that passes through our door, is acknowledged and appreciated. Your comments help to renew our spirit as we say goodbye to the current group of seniors and welcome in the new students during the next fall. Every teacher enjoys hearing from you and the kind words, no matter how small, you write on those cards during your senior year. It is very nice to know that the efforts to say hello at the beginning of the period and goodbye at the end of the day doesn't go unnoticed. Our hope is to help you see us as a mentor attempting to guide you through your journey and for you to understand that we care about you. I want you to know I believe in you. I know you can be great at whatever you decide to choose to do in the future, whether that's college, the military, or starting your career. I only want you to be the best at whatever you decide to do. When you work to be the best at any job, class, or communication, and you work to the best of your ability, no one can take that feeling of accomplishment away from you. By being the best you can be, you are important. You are showing anyone who knows you the character you have inside of you, and that is more important than anything you can be given. Think about anything that you have worked extremely hard to complete and the feeling of pride as you accomplished your goal. That feeling will last forever and will push you forward as you move forward in your life. Life won't always be easy and people won't always see how hard you work or the accomplishments. But understand, knowing you did the very best of your ability will carry you. There will come a time when you will be recognized for the effort you put into what you are doing. When that happens, it will refresh you and let you see that doing the right thing matters. In a very small way, this award accomplishes that action for me. Please walk away knowing that there are teachers here that care about you and are here for you. If you ever need someone to talk to in the future, you may leave Atholton High School, but Atholton High School will never leave you. Good luck as you move forward, and thank you again for this great honor. I am deeply humbled knowing how many amazing teachers there are at this school. Good day, and congratulations, class of 2020.
Hello, everyone. My name is Cherry Yoon, and I am the co-president of the SGA Executive Board. I am delighted to invite Howard County Executive Dr. Calvin Ball to address Atholton's class of 2020. Prior to his inauguration as county executive in 2018, Dr. Ball served as a county council member for 12 years. In 2006, he was elected the youngest chairperson ever to lead the county council. As Howard County's first African-American county executive, Dr. Ball has made it his priority to cultivate a unified and cohesive county and has since been recognized by the National Association of Counties Achievement Awards for Innovative and Effective Government. Please welcome Dr. Ball to the stand.
Hello, class of 2020. To all our graduates, let me join in the chorus of congratulations today. You have worked hard to make all your educators, families, and all of Howard County very proud. To all your family members and loved ones, thank you for your steadfast support of our graduates. As each of your names are called, you are joined in spirit by everyone who supported you, who provided for you, and who loved you throughout your life. Obviously, today looks a bit different than we may have imagined. And while this virtual celebration was not part of the original plan, consider how incredible it is that now so many loved ones from around the world can tune in and share in this recognition of your accomplishments. A word that has come up frequently in the past couple of months is perseverance. Perseverance has defined this moment, but it's been constant since the beginning of time. Perseverance may look different to everyone, but it continues to be a force that pushes humanity forward. In the past 12 years, you've certainly learned of Abraham Lincoln's perseverance, whose advice stands true today when he said, "Always bear in mind that your own resolution to succeed is more important than any other one thing." There's the perseverance of scientists who, despite campaigns against their findings and some stubborn politicians, continue to inform our global population about climate change? And how can we forget the perseverance of our ancestors? Those who fought for freedom, for the right to vote, for peace, or for justice. Here and around our world, there's the perseverance of teachers who have rapidly adapted their methods and embraced new technology and new ways to help teach and help ensure that you can learn. There's the perseverance of you, our 2020 seniors. Your stories didn't start 2 months ago. They didn't even start 12 years ago. But you've persevered through grammar, times tables, and reading aloud in front of a whole class. You've persevered through new schools and new friends, learning how to play an instrument or trying out for a sport. You persevered through trigonometry or geometry or one of those math classes that has more letters than numbers. You persevered through the uncertainty of your final semester and made it here today. Each of these moments where you persisted through challenges or changes have prepared you for whatever is on the horizon, and I have no doubt that you will all find much success in the future and make our world a better place. Today, we celebrate you, your incredible accomplishments, and your ability to always persevere. Congratulations, class of 2020, you did it.
Good evening. I'm Mr. Motley and the very proud principal of Atholton High School. I'm thrilled to be a part of this virtual commencement ceremony for the class of 2020. As I begin, I'd like to take a moment to acknowledge my awesome administrative team, Ms. Nasir, Mr. Richmond, Ms. Veslaney, and Mr. Sinisi, for their leadership, friendship, and endless support. I have the utmost respect for each of them and consider myself so fortunate to be a part of such a great team. We all know the journey that led us to this virtual ceremony. The rain on our cap and gown distribution day could not damper our spirits. However, words cannot express how grateful I am for the hard work and time put into making this ceremony a success by a great number of individuals. First and foremost, a shout out to the production company Show Call for pulling everything together. The wonderful support from our superintendent, Dr. Martirano, and his school management division. Our PTSA, who went above and beyond the call of duty for our graduates with gifts. The teachers for volunteering their own time to deliver yard signs and collect materials. And of course, our graduation coordinator, Ms. Bonomo Thomas. For you see, for us to arrive at this ceremony this evening, it took a village, the Atholton Village, and I'm so proud to be a part of it. I am sure I echo the sentiment of the class of 2020 when I say that we greatly appreciate all of your endless efforts to make not only this ceremony, but the year a memorable one. I'd also like to take a moment to recognize the teachers of Atholton High School. Their hard work and dedication, both in the classroom and out, have been instrumental in helping our graduates get to where they are today. So thank you, teachers, for what you do on a daily basis. Last and certainly not least, our parents. Where would we be without you? You are behind the scenes, encouraging, counseling, and guiding our seniors to this point. Congratulations, and take the time to treasure this moment. You deserve a round of applause. Class of 2020, let's hear it for your parents. Now, graduates. Here we are, you did it. And more than any other graduating class in history, everyone will remember yours, 2020. While you may feel it's for the wrong reasons, I am challenging each of you to look at the positives from this experience. Most importantly, I want you to think about how this experience has provided you the gift of time. Now, I have witnessed the constant, on-the-go, overbooked lives of many of you in this class. And if anything, you were forced to accept this gift of time. The gift of time to allow you to spend it with your families, the time to do things that you normally would not have the time to do, the time, to use more colloquial terms, to chill, to veg, to chillax, right? So let us focus on this gift of time and how it has allowed you to stop and smell the roses, how it has afforded you the opportunities to explore other things. Let's take away some positives from this experience. It is no secret that the last third of this year has been a challenge. In addition to that positive gift of time I spoke about, I now want to challenge you, class of 2020, to be the leaders that I know you are. We are all aware that our normal has forever changed. But you, class of 2020, are charged with creating our new normal. What an awesome responsibility that is, and one that I know each of you is capable of handling. I'm looking forward to your leadership in this endeavor, and I feel strongly that our county, state, country, and world are all in good hands. Now, I'm just finishing my second year in Atholton, and although I wasn't here when you began your high school journey, I am deeply humbled and honored to be here as it ends. I have enjoyed building relationships with you and sharing in the experiences that have made up your senior year. So let's take a stroll down memory lane, shall we? Our exciting basketball team and their march to the state semifinals. Let's not forget our outstanding senior wrestlers. And what about the awesome band, orchestra, and choir winter concerts and the fall production of She Kills Monsters? Also the spectacular dance concert and the extraordinary BSU and Bully Free Forever assemblies. And I can't forget the robotics, Science Olympiad, and MESA competitions. I have truly enjoyed celebrating with you this year. Oh, and we can't forget my cart zooming around the hallways, right? And Miss Lizlaney and her scooter, OMG, right? Now, academically, you are an impressive group of young individuals. You have garnered over $15 million in scholarship support and recognition. This class, whether you're off to a 2 or 4 year college or university, off to serve our country in the armed forces, or off to the world of work, you are prepared to take on the challenges that lie before you. To conclude, I want to acknowledge your hard work. I spoke of your teachers and your parents and family members and their role in your success, but you seniors, you have proven your incredible abilities over the course of your studies, and I salute you. All of your studying, researching, reading, test-taking, presenting, writing, and overall engagement has finally paid off. You are unstoppable and will continue to succeed. Don't get ready, be ready for all the world has to offer you and adapt accordingly. Life is a journey, not a destination, which requires continuous growth and elevation. As your principal, I am proud of you and excited to have been a part of your journey. I have such fond memories of our time together at Atholton. Remember, as you move forward, to accomplish what you never have, you must do something you have never done. Congratulations to you, and I'm excited to witness how you shape and create a new reality for us all. Congratulations, class of 2020. And now, class of 2020, a special surprise. 2 Atholton graduates heard about our virtual ceremony and wanted to contribute. All the way from Hollywood, California, please join me in welcoming a message from celebrity actors and fellow Raiders, DeWanda Wise and Josh Kelly.
Class of 2020. Hi. This is really wild for me because I feel like I'm talking into the future. I'm DeWanda Wise. I'm sorry, I didn't give you a proper introduction. a very, very proud graduate of Atholton. My dad went to Atholton. When I was there, I was student speaker, I was all in. But this is not a moment that's about me. This is a moment that's about you. And I know that this year must feel crazy. And on the one hand, I have some hard news. Hard news is this is life. The good news is you are so equipped to handle it. I mean, so absolutely equipped. And I really believe with the wholeness of my heart that there is nothing that could actually take away from this moment of celebration. I'm thinking about you, your family, your friends, your teachers, obviously, the administration, the entirety of the Howard County Public School System is thinking about you. And, you know, I'm so excited to see what your class, specifically your class, makes happen in the future, in small ways, in large ways, in your communities, in your jobs, in your families, globally. And yeah, I choose to be excited, and I hope you do too. I hope you know you are ready. I hope you know you are worthy. I hope you know you are brilliant. And any fear and any anxiety, any of those things that you feel, remember, you can always channel them. You can always use them as fuel. And the more things you go through in your lives, you know, not to be obnoxiously old and condescending, but they all go somewhere. So I look forward to seeing where this goes for all of us. Congratulations.
Hello. Whoa, guys, settle down. Jeez, all right, okay. Atholton High School, class of 2020. Hi, I'm Josh Kelly. I'm an actor, former Army Ranger, and three-time Howard County wrestling champion, junior varsity. And I'm a graduate of Atholton High School, back from the year 2000, before you guys were born. So in prep for this graduation speech, I watched a bunch of other graduation and commencement speeches on YouTube. I watched like Mark Zuckerberg and Steve Jobs, other people, heads of industry. And I tried to think of whatever kernels of knowledge I could impart on the powerful young minds of the world's future leaders and artists and innovators. Then I realized I'm an actor. I play make-believe for a living. And other people get paid a lot of money to write what I say on screen. But I also realized I could tell my story. So that's what you guys get to hear. I have been successful in two difficult fields, and I did graduate from Atholton High School. So I figured what I should do was go back to 20 years ago when I graduated and see what I had to say. So fortunately, Mrs. Lerner, well, Miss Lerner, now Mrs. Kreiner, her first year as a teacher was my English teacher. And she had us do a report on ourselves. I still have mine. I'm gonna read some of it to you. Hello, my name is Josh Kelly. I am a 5'10", 220-pound, 18-year-old German-Irish boy. I live in Columbia, Maryland, in a nice little planned community. By the time I'm 28 years old, I'm going to be a superstar. This summer, I'm joining the United States Army to become a Special Forces Ranger. After 4 years of jumping out of planes, blowing up stuff, blah, 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 then off to Hollywood. Anyways, point was, I'm not a superstar, but for the past 14 years, I have been able to make a living doing what I love, which is acting. And I found some interesting correlations between acting and the process of becoming an actor and becoming an Army Ranger. So I joined the Army. I assumed that becoming a Ranger would probably be difficult, but I was Mr. HS, so I could do it. Once I got the basic training, I started hearing all these horror stories about how difficult it was, how impossible it was. I didn't want to let my dad down. I realized I'd already told everyone that I was going to make it. Put it in this report. I even put it in my yearbook. But I decided it wasn't going to scare me too much. I worked hard. I started out as the fat kid in basic training in the platoon. But I did push-ups at night on guard duty, and I ended up becoming the platoon honor graduate. Then it was time for airborne school. I started to notice something. Some of the guys that we had just gone through basic training together in infantry school, some of the guys, the same guys that we, like on downtime, kitchen duties, we talk about how we're all gonna become Rangers together, or be tough guys. These guys started to quit before we even went to airborne school. I mean, they quit before they even had a chance to fail. Then the same thing happened after airborne school. By the way, I'm terrified of heights still. Thought I'd get over it by jumping out of airplanes. Did not. On the way of going to the Ranger indoctrination program, when given the option to quit, even more of these guys quit. Before we even did anything, my Ranger indoctrination program class started with 256 people and only 21 of us graduated. That's about a 92% attrition rate. But I'm here and I'm telling you guys, barely any of them actually failed. We all had just been through a bunch of military training. We were in great physical shape, but when given the easy option, they quit. They didn't fail, they quit. So only two of us, my best friend Rylan and I, ended up making it into the Rangers from our basic training class. I went on a Ranger battalion and I learned a bunch of stuff, but I'll tell you guys that in 4 years when you graduate college. Some of you, longer than that, but that's okay. That leads me to my next story. I was getting ready to get out of the Army, so I visit Atholton and I go talk to Mr. Rosen, drama teacher, and I ask him what theater school I should go to. He told me that I was pretty good at acting in high school. After 4 tours of duty to Afghanistan and Iraq, I had a great life experience. So if I really wanted to become an actor, and that's the key, if I really wanted to, I should go become an actor. Live where actors live, either New York or Los Angeles. Maybe take some acting classes while you're there. So I moved out here to LA, and I still live here. I took a lot of acting classes. I started to recognize a familiar pattern. So in the beginning of my acting classes, friend group, we were all bright-eyed, bushy-tailed. We were ready to conquer the dramatic world. We're all gonna become famous and start production companies together and win Academy Awards together and Emmys. And then time went on and it was hard. People's side jobs became their full-time jobs. And one by one, just like in the Army, people started dropping off because they didn't get auditions, or the auditions they did get, they didn't book. Now, I looked this up for you guys. So I'm not a superstar, as you probably know. Like I said in my yearbook, I was going to. But I have been in over 45 film and TV projects, and I've done over 200 episodes of television. I was on a soap opera for a year, so that kind of pads the numbers. But for the last 14 years, I, honest to God, have been able to pay the bills doing what I love, which is acting. Why have I been able to do that? How? Why couldn't my other friends in acting class not do that? Well, because what it doesn't show on the internet, what you can't Google, is the hundreds upon hundreds of auditions that I've been on, and I didn't get. I stopped counting at around 900. I'm not kidding. Like hundreds, thousands, I guess thousands. I've bombed. I've been real bad. I've been okay. I've almost got stuff. But the reason I'm still a working actor is because I love this job. I want to succeed at it, and I won't quit. The difference between success and failure in difficult fields is the unwillingness to quit. Just like in the Army, there are only two of us from acting class. And Jeff just sold two movie scripts. And once this quarantine's over, I'm going to be starting a new TV show on Fox. It's hopefully going to be really good. Hope you guys like it. So I guess what I'd like to say to you guys to think about, you should set goals, but be open to change. You're going to learn a lot and you're going to change a lot. Don't be too hard on yourself when you fail, but also don't let it become a habit. Learn from it. Use those lessons to prevent it from happening again. Go after what you love or you will regret it. Don't quit on yourself. Your heart will be broken, but it will heal. It's annoying. It's really annoying. But it really does just take time. And take pride in everything you do, even when it's not what you want to be doing. Because only you know where you're going. And only you know where you are going will be great. When I worked at Hickory Ridge Subway as a sandwich artist, I took pride in my work. Because I knew where I was going. Don't underestimate the value of being nice. Being authentically nice can get you hired and can definitely keep you from getting fired. I've learned that. And like Winston Churchill said, success is not final, failure is not fatal. So go out there, have fun. The world is yours now. Thank you.
Board Member Kirsten Coombs and Dr. Martirano, as principal of Atholton High School, I hereby certify that the members of the class of 2020 have met all the requirements for graduation as set forth by the Howard County Public School System and the Maryland State Department of Education. They are eligible to receive a Maryland High School diploma, a certificate of completion, certificate of attendance, or certificate of achievement.
It is my honor to introduce our next distinguished guest, Dr. Michael Martirano. Dr. Martirano has been an educator for more than 35 years and has a wide range of educational and administrative experience through his work as a science teacher, principal, and visiting professor at Johns Hopkins University. For the past 2 years, Dr. Martirano has served as superintendent of the Howard County Public School System and has worked to foster an inclusive and nurturing learning environment for all Howard County students. Thank you, Dr. Martirano, for joining us today.
Greetings, and I want to begin by saying congratulations to the class of 2020. You have persevered academically for over 12 years, and I am so proud of you and confident that you are ready for the next chapter of your life. You have achieved your goals both inside the classroom and outside the classroom, all while displaying and exhibiting solid character. Ultimately, who you are as a person will determine your lifelong success, fulfillment, and happiness. Having strong character involves hard work, perseverance, and grit. It means you have resilience, passion, and determination. Most of all, good character means always reaching down to give others a hand up. I commend the positive attitude and level of resilience that you have displayed, especially during these last several months. You have shown truly exceptional character. Class of 2020, I am in awe of your spirit and tenacity. Your optimistic and hopeful spirit serves as a model for all who interact with you. One of my favorite poets is Robert Frost, and his poem, "The Road Not Taken," is my favorite. Its words have a poignancy that is most symbolic and relevant for this time. The final stanza of this poem reads as follows: "I shall be telling this with a sigh. Somewhere ages and ages hence, two roads diverged in a wood, and I took the one less traveled by, and that has made all the difference. To you as graduates, you have been on the road less traveled. I encourage you to stay on that path and forge your own road. Your chosen path should be one that leads to your fulfillment and happiness. Capitalizes on all you can to forge a future that will make a difference for others and helps to define a new and brighter future for humankind. Your diploma gives you the opportunity to truly make change in the world. As we grapple with the social-emotional impacts of the pandemic that may have forever changed our daily lives, we have recently witnessed another senseless killing of an African-American, George Floyd. It is important that we acknowledge this event, reflect on the hurt and pain we are feeling, and resolve together to do our part to eradicate hate, condemn violence, and stand up to acts of racism within our own communities. The great writer James Baldwin said it best, "Not everything that is faced can be changed, but nothing can be changed until it is faced." The best way for us to move forward is to face it head on, talk about it, and take actions that prevent this from happening again. I implore you to lead with vulnerability and empathy. Be change leaders for justice and create peaceful opportunities and spaces for people to share and heal together. The only way to eradicate hate is to lead with love, care, and compassion. If I can foreshadow our future, you, my beautiful students, are my hope for better days ahead and a better society. Be gentle and be kind. Be patient and persistent. Be other-centered and lead with equity as your core value. Be empathic, caring, and compassionate. Be upstanders, not bystanders. Be agents of change and be the love in the world, because love is the force that can illuminate and transcend all of humankind. You have an amazing opportunity and have a view like none who have come before you. Your perspective will be electrifying. Your generation will be known as the ones who truly changed the trajectory of our future. Choose to take the road less traveled and make the difference that your journey along the road will reveal. To the class of 2020, I wish you love, joy, and most of all, happiness. Congratulations.
Our next speaker is Ms. Kirsten Coombs, the current vice chair of Howard County's Board of Education and a proud Howard County parent. Ms. Coombs has served as the chair of the Board of Education's Legislative Committee for 2 years, taking a collaborative and balanced approach to help solve challenges in the community. She is a strong advocate for empowering educators' voices in decision-making, strengthening special education services, supporting vulnerable populations in the community, and more. I'm honored to welcome Ms. Coombs to the stage.
Greetings to all of our students, their families, and friends. There are two special days each year for me as a Board of Education member. On the first day of school, you can feel the excitement and the promise of new opportunities. You can see the trepidation of kindergartners as they step off the bus. You can see the first graders' faces with the, "I got this," as they hurry to greet their old friends and new teachers. The fifth graders with their tweenage, whatever faces, trying to hide their happiness at seeing friends. I always love to go to the elementary schools on the first day. But the second special day is graduation. This year, we are celebrating apart from each other. We don't know when we'll be able to gather in person to celebrate together. That uncertainty is defining your graduation. You may feel apart, but know that all of you are dealing with that uncertainty. For the planners out there with 1 month, 6 month, 2 year goals, that can be overwhelming. This Howard County diploma, regardless of how you receive it, is still a golden ticket. For the students, this is a reference to Willy Wonka. For us older folk, it's Charlie and the Chocolate Factory. What will you do with your golden ticket? If you move too fast, you could succumb to the fate of Violet Beauregard, who is so obsessed with chewing gum quickly that she ends up as a blueberry being rolled out by an Oompa Loompa. Or be like Vuur Casalt, demanding a squirrel and getting the golden goose and trying to use money and her spoiled rotten antics on her father only to have the egg decator declare her a bad egg and be covered in garbage. Why don't you be like Charlie Bucket? He recognizes that his family has made sacrifices for him, much like yours have for you. He knows the value of his family over candy. He also recognizes when he has made a mistake. And in recognizing that mistake and returning the gobstopper to Willy Wonka, he actually receives the bigger reward, the chocolate factory. What you choose to do with your golden ticket is up to you. I encourage you to use the opportunities it presents you and be ever grateful for your parents and family that got you to this achievement. Your success is to be celebrated, and I hope that you have a chance to enjoy your accomplishment. Congratulations to you all. At this time, please join me in honoring the class of 2020 as we now recognize each of our graduates.
Ajar Khalid Abdel Mutagali. Dawood Abdullah Ibn Nasir Abdul Malik. Abin Abraham. Tima Aza Uzwegbu Achuko. John Lewis Adam. Adebayu Adamuyiwa Adatunji. Victoria Adler. Fola Ajimu. Elizabeth Diane Ake. Sana Fatima Ali. Nicholas Edward Allen. Michael Leo Altamirano. Yula Nana Ando. Maxime Francis Arbereri. Jillian Elizabeth Armstead. Ayumikun Faseyu Ayeni. Lucas Oliver Baglioni. John Stephen Bailey. Monica Ferracabris Bailey. Alice Farah Baker. Neha Banerjee. Matthew Dayung Bang. Emma Lee Barker. Aiden Paul Barker. Liliana Grace Barrett. Zoe Francesca Baskerville. Devin Bernadette Bouts. Nidhi Baxi. Mariam Ahmed Beg. Natnael Malay. Jessica Nicole Bell. Marvin Lee Belshis III. Kate Olivia Bendel. Craig Frederick Benjamin Jr. Charleston Loreen Berkheimer. Grant Malcolm Billard. Natalie Sophia Blair. Madeline Marisa Blanford. Christopher Michael Buchter. Thomas Andrew Bott. Luke Robert Bowling. George Edward Bradford II. Cedric William Coposa Bricken. Emma Carly Brown. Ethan Quintus Brown. Gerald Rishon Brown.
Micah Janaki Brown. Raymond James Brown. Imani Nicole Bullock. Leif Eric Burns. Joshua Lundy Burton. Michael Edgar Burton Jr.
Quadre Delano Campbell.
Tori Andrew Campbell. Noel G. Sun Campisi. Carla Vanessa Cantarero. Sarah Ashley Carlisle. Kayla Crystal Carter.
Samara Blair Catherell.
Susan Dorothy Solano. Sky Sija Sen. Sophia Irie Cheatham. Carly Lynn Chalemi. Sue Ann Cho. Caleb Choi. David Choi. Nolan Patrick Chong. Olivia Claire Chori. Chase Daniel Clark. Sarah Elaine Clark. Caitlin Elizabeth Clemens. London Alicia Cobb. Colia Andrew Cochran. Paige Lillian Cohen. Rose Minju Collins. Dorothy Grace Elizabeth Cordes. Sarah Margaret Cornell. Liliana Sarah Cortez. Jordan Emily Cosgrove. Desmond Carlton Craig. Mariah Michelle Crandell. Maxwell Anthony Kreider. Clifton Lionel Cunningham II. Zachary Scott Currier. Justin Charles Curry. Michelle Lee Curry. Star Deshae Daniel. Gabriel Daniel Davila. Oxa Marit Delgado Menendez. Sydney DeLuca. Leela Jasmine Durstein. Benjamin Oliver Digby. Nathaniel Doan.
Devin James Donato. Tiffany Dong. Evan Michael Dorney Canis. Tony Montana Dorsey. Joseph Daniel Duckhorn. Brandon Sivu Duke. Niera Taylor Dula. James Hugh Duncan III. Hannah Elizabeth Eccles. Erin Grace Edwards. Owen Alexander Enk. Cheyenne Farhad Etemadi. Dylan Douglas Evans. Medyame Tesfe Ayob. Emma Jean Faber. Ethan Hualun Fan. Michaela Hines Farachi. Iman Faruqi. Nathaniel Joseph Feldman. Madison Charlotte Fitzgerald. Daniel Patrick Florenzo. Violeta Flores. Jordan Sean Four. Devante Emil Francis. Janie Ann Gardinier. Alexandra Grace Gardner. Blaise Michael Garner. Madison Nicole Garrigus.
Annabella Rose Gaudet.
Zachary Taylor Giesman. Nadine Aaliyah Gillen. Liza Ariane Goldberg. Cameron Kiernan Goodwinshow. Sydney Marie Grant. Janiel Samoy Gray. James Jeffrey Greenwood. James Rylan Greets. John Randolph Greets. Jeremiah Emmanuel Griffiths. Hari Chandana Gompena. Benjamin Zansu Gu. Anna Louise Hall. McKenna Autumn Hamill. Cameron Elise Harris. Dwayne Anthony Harris II. Miles Xavier Ife Hartgrove. Cameron George Hassett.
Lena Hassan Hassan. Zachary David Heck. Chelsea Wangari Henia. Aiden Thomas Herring. Megan Elizabeth Hessler. Kane Armin Hines. Gerald Ronald Hinton. Kimberly Dean Ho. Richard L. Ho. Andrew Herbert Hawk. Marissa Mamie Hollingshed. Brandy Trishlyn Holtmeyer. Jackson Titus Howard. Mason Gabriel Howell. Jessica Denise Humphreys. Christopher Ipefua. Yula Namachuku Irabor. Lindsay Claire Jackson. Nyla Jagdahan. Abedin Amir Jallo. Taylor Elizabeth James. Toshiba Miyabaya James. Bryce Damon Jamison. David Sangmin Jang. Seung Jang. Daisel Jong. Bridget Colleen Jessel. Brittany Hollis Johnson. Samuel Kenneth Johnson. Samuel Il Wong Jung. Diane Jihad Kabir. Luke John Kadingo. Sriharsha Kankanahali. Faraz Abdul Karim. Rachel Jean Kashak. Jermor Charles Kent Jr. Cassidy Elizabeth Kerrigan. Leanne Kaskia. Ariana Kianpur. Caleb Hyungjoon Kim. Christina Myung Kim. Justin Min Kim. Nathan Hyungwoo Kim. Noah Anthony Kim. Yuna Kim.
Noah Miguel Byron Kindred. Maria Carmen Kirk. Andrew Nicholas Codsey. Sophie Lillian Cohn. Bradley Joel Konigstein. Nolan Marsh Krasnick. Anna Maria Kulikova. Mahir Karup. Alvin Naveen Lakra. Olivia Holly Lamp. Maya Anique Lampkins. Charlotte Joyce Lang. Riley Marie Law. Shelby Lila Lechner. Janice Jin Lee. May Sarah Lee. Stephanie D. Lee. Mariana Antonia Lennon. Natalie Ava Lewis. Zichao Liang. Dante Henry Xavier Ligon. Tashiana Lesulo. Tahila Lesulo. Corey Michael Long. Lana Dior Yong Lee. Matthew Richard McDonald. Lucas Maxwell Maggio. Carl Andrew Vascua Malikdom. Laura De Lima Matos Frede Diaz Pacifico Manabuski. Anastasia Manzari. Luke Samuel Marlowe. Dominique Joy Martin. Manuel Martin. Antonio David Martinez. Hannah June Matrangula. Maxwell John Mavromatis. Liam Jack Mayhew. Maurice Bernard Mayo III. Kelsey Deborah McElroy. Kashante Tanaya McIntosh Benbow. James William McKenna Soto. Preston Noel McMillan. Andrew Ryan McNamara. Ellie Rhodes Meeks. Jessely Giselle Mejia Gallo.
Gerardo Mendez Andrade. Justin DeFong King Meyer. Louisa Mahari Tekle Michael. Darren James Miller. Davis James Missner. Daniel Michael Monk. Gabrielle Chung Ming Muma. Jalen Adam Moore. Will Anthony Morales. Erica Grace Morton. Brian Edward Muchmore. Kevin Logan Munford. Jonathan Joshua Mwasigwa. Sarah Rachel Myers. Ty B. Nockenberg. Brandon Bin Nguyen. Ethan Michael Nguyen. Justine Kim To Nguyen. Tony Alexander Nieto. Vincent Conrad Nimmo. Shane David O'Brien. Jordan Will Oates. Alexander Stephen Oberle. Kira Christine Weathersby O. Donovan Hans Okalita. Temitopa Okacha. Matthew James Oliver. Alexis Ayomidi Oni. Machuku Oradubanya. Andrew John Orlowski. Michael James Orlowski. Gavin Daniel Osborne. Daniel Seymour Asheroff. Cole Vincent Alton. Aisha Idris Palmer. David Panda. Joshua Peter Panapento. Kian Parsa. Dimple Ganshiam Patel. Maya Mahesh Patel. Sage Camille Peterson. Danny Wang Fan. Joel Christian Popa. Ethan Emery Post. Sean Donnell Powell Jr. Keenan Elizabeth Proctor. Kelly Alexandria Pryor.
Anthony Ewing Pusilowski. Corey William Humphrey. Charlize Juanis Quiñones Ayoso. J. Kishore Rajpara. Yesenia Guadalupe Ramirez Romero. Jabari Ray Rankin. Daniel Gideon Rapp. Yamini Ravi. Benjamin Philip Recht. Spencer David Rhodes. Kendall Lynn Richard. Kamau Abednego Nehemiah Richardson. William Alexander Richman. Neve Kamari Rivers. Ava Danielle Robb. Shayna Rebecca Rogofsky. Saul River Rugal. Michelle Philip Roy. Christian Alexander Rosso. Sebastian Edward Rua. Matthew Junsuk Ree. Davija Rasi Sadula. Andrew Burton Sage. Harshveer Singh Sani. Jaden Allen Anthony Sally. Rebecca Luna Sanchez Castro. Isha Santosh. Bella Naomi Saunders. Nicole Marie Schmidt. Nathan Charles Scholar. Lauren Emily Selznick. Renee Dola Sen. Chloe Sparrow Shader. Enoch Albert Shahzad. Maniraj Naga Shunmugam. Akanksha Sharma. Zoe Wei Shi. Grant Everett Shields. Sebastian Kevin Moran Silberman. Hanan Vieira Silva. Ezra Zach Silver-Eisenstadt. Carrie Alyssa Silverstein. Colleen Marie Simmerly. Ishan Singh. Sachi Neet Singh. Nicholas Aaron Sloan.
Chanel Grace Smith. Dakara Shirley Smith. Gia Latanya Smith. Lila Jolie Smith. Annabelle Nicole Smoot. Heather W. Sohn. Denari Elijah Spears. Anna Maylee Stevens. Amber Nicole Stewart. Kira Catherine Stewart. Devin Jamal Stokes. Chloe Alexandra Sullivan. John Michael Sutton. Ian Clark Swartz. Emma Lynn Simprich. Brian Allen Tarantino. Trinity Morgan Tatum. Robert Benjamin Taylor. Benjamin Jacob Thomas Thalheimer. Isaiah Maurice Thaxton. Matthew Christopher Thomas. Crystalline Lay Toe.
Eric Z. Tu. Joshua Segovia Tudela. Michaela Saray Teray.
Rohan Amit Uttam Singh.
Lindsay Lore Vandermeed. Manharsha Virk. Christy Bao Vong. Eric Omar Walker. Eileen C. Wong. Kinsley Marie Wargo. Naomi Joy Washington. Jonathan William Watkins. Allison Kate Welch. Elena Patricia Wenderoth. Ronald Anthony White III. Julia Clark Whitney. Savannah Jolie Wright.
Jessica Ushen Wu.
Raymond Zhu. Isabella Sky Yakono. Chera Yoon. Stephen Ore Young. Sanaya Zaira Zaidi. Zachary Thomas Zamer.
Congratulations, Atholton Class of 2020. We did it!
It has been an honor serving as your senior class president and vice president this school year.
We would like to take a moment to thank our classmates, teachers and staff, the families who made today possible, and those who put on our virtual graduation.
As we graduate, we hope that, although these are not ideal circumstances, you all fondly remember the past 4 years, and we wish you nothing but the best in your future endeavors.
We are so proud of all you've accomplished and how you've truly made our class the best it can be. It's been a challenge going through such an uncertain time. However, it just goes to show how we will continue to persevere through the future. We are so excited to see all you do until we meet again.
We hope you take the skills that you have learned the past 13 years with you as we become young adults. Now, will the Atholton High School graduating class of 2020 please stand for the turning of the tassel?
Congratulations, seniors. I am so proud of all that you've accomplished. Good luck out there.
To the class of 2020 Atholton High School, my lunch brunch friends, be safe, be well. Your journey has just begun.
Congratulations, Atholton Raiders, class of 2020. Love you.
I just wanted to say congratulations. I'm so sorry it all had to end in this unique fashion. However, don't for a second let that take away from all that you've accomplished. Take care, best of luck, love you guys.
Congratulations, class of 2020. Just like this cylinder, you've graduated.
Congrats, class of 2020.
Congratulations, Raiders. Best luck in the future. In the words of Maya Angelou, if you don't like something, change it. And if you can't, change your attitude. Come back and visit.
Hola, this is Senora Grady, class of 2020. I just want to tell you guys, thank you so much. This is Mateo, for coming into my life. And I know you guys are about to start a new chapter. I know it was kind of different way to start a new chapter, but you know, I believe through adversity, people do great things. You guys are going to be amazing. We have high expectations. I know you'll do great. Keep in contact. I wish you all the best. Remember, treat others the way you want to be treated. I'll miss you guys. Love you guys.
Congratulations, class of 2020. You guys have proven that you're strong, you're courageous, you're tenacious. Never lose sight of who you are as you embark upon this new journey called life. Once again, congratulations.